My name is Vera Scroggins, S-C-R-O-G-G-I-S. I'm from Brackley, Pennsylvania, Susquehanna County. I want to say that I moved here out of the urban area. I was raised near Linden, New Jersey. I was raised in Elizabeth, New Jersey, which is right next to a refinery. So I know what it's like to breathe toxic fumes on a regular basis. And I know what it's like to have poor quality air, and not just from a refinery, but all kinds of industry that is there. So I'm very concerned that when I came here, I came for clean air and clean water. And I'm concerned that now these compressor stations are going to be built one after another. We have three that are proposed right now in the Springville area within a 5-mile radius. How many are proposed for this area? You have one now proposed, and I hear from the woman that spoke before me that 60 homes are within a 1-mile radius. Now, this is considered a class one facility. If you have 60 homes within a 1-mile radius, I think you might want to reconsider the classification. Do a study to see if this is truly a class one area. And with class one, you have hardly any regulations. The industry themselves police themselves. And I would like to see this facility reevaluated, so maybe it's a class two or even higher, so that you will have more regulations and the intervention of the PUC and any other agencies that might be involved. We have families there, and like I just heard now, 30 children. So the impact of the air quality will be changed, because it's not just one compressor station. There is usually, from what I've seen in the pattern right now, additional ones are proposed and built. So after this one is built, you will see others, because of the additional pipelines that go in, the additional gas, there's so much gas that might come through. So be prepared, Washington Township, for several compressor stations. So I feel this is an injustice to the people of this state, this county, and this is not right for any of us to have to deal with, and to do studies that are long-term while this is happening is also an injustice. Why don't you do the studies first and hold off any more building of any more compressor stations? Because not only the compressor stations emit, but so do the gas sites and the pipes themselves, and this is just additional. So every time you have another station, you have more being emitted. So how long will your long-term study go for? Is it like usual studies? A year, 2 years, 3 years? And meanwhile, all the building continues. And then we have to breathe this. And this is absolutely outrageous and disgraceful. And this is happening in our country. 30 counties in this state are being sacrificed so that this industry can do whatever it wants, so that they can just take advantage and make all the profit it wants at our expense, and at the expense of our health and the future generations of this state and of this country. This needs to be stopped and not allowed at all. And I've lost faith in this country. I've lost faith in our political process and our leaders. Profit is not the major reason why we do things. Jobs are not the major reason why we do things. We do things because it's for the health and well-being of everyone. Not just those who want to make a profit, not just those who have land, who think that the air pollution and the water pollution does not spread beyond their facility. That is not the case. We are all affected, and it goes downstream, downhill, and it affects everyone. So I am very concerned about this aggregate, the cumulative studies, and put everything on a moratorium until these studies are done, and then you can possibly allow this industry if it passes the studies. And we don't have to be subjugated to this. Just because we live in the country and there's this low population, and that you can think you can do whatever you want, and you really can't. And I hope justice will prevail.
Thank you.